These are my comments on Professor Paul Krugman's article in the New York Times, Depression Denial Syndrome, from October 3rd, 2014. First off, I want to just bring up that this is something that the professor has brought up numerous times. This has to deal with the fact that there are a great number of people in the financial industry and all the support people that support them who have basically been in denial about the fact that this depressed economy needs to be treated differently than as if it is a roaring economy or anything else. One of the things that many of these people have been advocating since 2009, which has basically been 5 full years, is that inflation is around the corner and that we need to protect ourselves from inflation and cut deficits, et cetera, et cetera. And that has been wrong all along. The professor links to an article on Bloomberg where just yesterday, a number of them who had written a letter to the Federal Reserve in 2009 about inflation coming roaring back are standing by their arguments. And their arguments are dead wrong, and they've been dead wrong for the last 5 years. The Fed has been printing money, but that's a different story. But the basic element is that they've been able to keep inflation down by printing money, as they say. All right, it hasn't hurt the economy. We haven't had roaring inflation. The deficits are not out of control. But again, these people seem to keep going on the same thing, and in essence, in the long term, it is hurting the economy. Now, the professor goes into one particular person whose firm had actually done well until one person left. And that person was not in depression denial, but the current person is, who just left the company. And that, of course, they bet wrong, and the company got hurt by it. And the thing is that how many people have been hurt by this for the last 5 years? Not only the people at the top, but the people at the bottom, because this is what it is all about. It is all about trying to keep the people from the bottom getting the goods and services that they need so that we can move on. Now, again, because interest rates have been low for the last 5 years, this would have been the most appropriate time for the federal government to borrow money so that they can make investments in education, in infrastructure, in jobs, in the electrical grid, you know, all kinds of things that we need to make investments in. But because there was all this hysteria in reference to the deficit and looming inflation, they couldn't do that. Plus, the political system of the Republicans was basically, we don't want to invest in anything. We want to become a third world country. Because as long as we're a third world country, we'll still have ultra billionaires. But so that was their premise. And the thing was, is that when interest rates are low and the public sector is not investing anything, it doesn't hurt the private sector, it doesn't hurt the government to buy, to invest at that time, because they're not competing with the private sector. I think I got my sectors wrong there for a second. But now the government can borrow money, and it's not going to affect the interest rates because the other end was not investing. Right? So these are things, I know they sound a little, you know, iffy, but again, even before 2009, we know these things to be true. But there was a certain element of people in the financial sector that were backed up by people in the political sector who basically didn't want to invest in the economy, who were screaming and yelling that deficits were out of control, who were screaming and yelling that inflation is right around the corner, and none of that was true. So here we have a depressed economy for the last 5 or 6 years. We've known how to get out of it. We knew how to get out of it beforehand. We had a number of examples of how that had been done and how it could be done, but we refused to have the political will to do that. So we still have, maybe our unemployment rate is down a little bit, but at the same time, we have a lot of people who aren't even looking for jobs because they can't find anything. They're tired of looking because there's nothing out there for them. We want to bring jobs to everyone. There is a lot of areas that the United States needs to invest in. And as I mentioned, one other one is the high-speed rail, public transportation, besides those other ones. And, you know, we have to have the will of the elected officials. And when the will of the elected officials is to do what the people in the financial industry say to them, and the people who are paying for their elections are telling them, we're not going to get that type of investment. The vast majority of that is coming from our friends on the Republican side, who don't want to invest in anything and think that the private sector can do everything. And it has proven, and that's how we got into this mess in the first place. And it has been proven time and time again that this just does not work. And again, kudos for the Professor Krugman to continue to bring this up, that the people at the top of the financial sector have been wrong. They've been continuously wrong. And why we are continually listening to them is way beyond anyone's imagination.